tell me if you're really there. Don't make me fall in love again if you won't be here next year.
And when the snow is falling down, 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 you'll know that Santa's back in town, town, town. That's when it's Christmas time again.
Guys, it's Christina and I am back with my what I want for Christmas video. And before I get started, I'm gonna do the boring disclaimer. Clearly this is a wish list, a want what I want for Christmas. Doesn't mean I'm going to get all these things, and I'm entitled to wish for things just like anybody else. People make thousands of these videos. No one is expecting the world for Christmas, but you can wish for it because you're entitled to wish for whatever you want. I can wish for, you know, Nick Jonas to lay in my bed right now. That doesn't mean it's gonna happen. Oh look, he's not there. And I will be showing this video to my mom, dad, and boyfriend, and they're probably all going to just be like, that's nice, you can keep on wishing. So probably not gonna get any of these things. So I'm just filming this video because I know for me it took me a minute to even be able to write this list because I wasn't sure what I wanted for Christmas at first, but then once I like saw like a magazine and started flipping through stuff and I watched some other people's what I want for Christmas videos from last year and this year, I was able to get more of an idea of things that I wanted for Christmas. Pretty much doing this video to help you guys out to think of something that you might want to ask for Christmas, or even if you have a friend or a sister or anybody who's into the kind of things that I'm into, you might be like, oh, I didn't even think of that. She would definitely want that for Christmas. So this is kind of just like a gift guide sort of video and a personal, you know, inspirational Christmas wishlist video. So without further ado, let's hop into it. So I have all of my wishes in the book. First one is world peace and the end of world hunger, because I can wish for what I want and that's what I'm wishing for. And also a car and a college degree without actually doing the work for it. So now for more tangible items. First thing I want is a cheese straightener. I've heard a lot about it, and actually at my old school my two roommates had it, and it was just really nice. Like, it literally worked on their hair and then it worked on my hair, and I'm just like, what kind of sorcery is this? So I'd really, really, really like to have that flat iron for Christmas. I'd also like to have some kind of a higher brand eyeshadow palette. Right now the only ones I have are e.l.f. It doesn't matter to me if it's the Naked palettes. Actually, I don't really understand all the hype for those. It kind of look like the same thing three times. I don't really notice the difference in high brand blushes and eyeshadows. I do notice the difference in mascaras and foundations, but not so much the permanent base stuff. So any kind of high end, it could be Bobbi Brown, it could be NYX, it could be Urban Decay, NYX. Could be whatever, I really don't care. I just want to try some kind of a high brand eyeshadow palette. I kind of want some more eyeshadow palettes. I would love to get like maybe three, mom, maybe like three eyeshadow palettes from BH Cosmetics. That would make me very happy. The actual like full-on palettes with like the black cases though, not like the little, you know, the ones that are like the 80s and the party girls and like the bright colored ones and like the themed ones, not those, but like the ones that are actually like legit 18 color, like I don't know, 24 color palettes, stuff like that. I would like that. So mom, you know, just mom's, you know, just, okay. Also, I would like the BH Cosmetics sculpting face brushes. I really like how they look, and I would like to have some more brushes that are also not e.l.f. I feel like a lot of my stuff besides like my foundations and mascaras and stuff are e.l.f. I like to try the higher end stuff before I just say, oh no, they're the same, they're the same. Because clearly there's a reason why everyone keeps buying these things. So I'd like to try them out. And I don't want to like jump into like high end right now, but PH Cosmetics I think is a really good starter for someone who's just starting out with makeup. and kind of wants to get into high end but doesn't really want to go splurging on just MAC and Sephora and Ulta right off the bat. The next thing I want is a Keurig. I've wanted a Keurig for a while now, and I just think it's nicer, it's easier to make my teas. I don't really drink coffee that much just because I don't feel like going through the trouble of making it, but I probably would drink it more if I had a Keurig. And I loved like seeing all the little different flavored Keurig drinks, and it's faster. Most morning routine girls are waking up and they're taking a shower and washing their face and then going downstairs and making their coffee. But in my real world, it's me waking up like 10 minutes before my class starts and throwing on clothes, brushing my teeth, and realizing I need to book it up the road before I'm late. So having a Keurig would basically be able to make me drink my tea and coffee in the morning like I'd like to, and that can be brewing as I'm getting my life situated, and I could probably have more of a decent morning even though I'm still gonna be late and everything. But I mean, coffee and tea makes everything better, so yeah. Next thing I want is a MAC nude lipstick. Finding a nude lipstick for my complexion is kind of difficult. There are girls who have been darker than me who can find nude lipsticks, and lighter than me that can find nude lipsticks, but I've never seen one. So I'm thinking MAC just because they have such an extensive color range that they might be able to have a color that would suit me very well. So I would like a nude lipstick from MAC. And I don't own my own MAC lipsticks. I just usually wear my mom's stuff, so I like to have my own. Next, I'd like some Bath & Body Works candles. I'd like to have some winter and like standard all year round ones so that I can burn them whenever I want. And the winter ones just all smell like the best bakery in the universe. So I'd like to have some of those. I'd also like a Victoria's Secret pink sweatshirt. I've been trying to get my hands on one for a while, but they're really expensive. And when they are on sale, they go really quick, so I'm always too late. So I'd like to finally get one of those. Also, I'd like some new tea, preferably like the loose tea. I really like loose tea. Yeah, I like loose tea a lot. From any company besides Teavana would be fine as well, but that would be really nice. I kind of stick to like chai teas or herbal tea. Some loose herbal tea would make me very, very happy. And also, I was watching My Life as Ava's Christmas Wishlist from last year. She had mentioned wanting some German rock sugar. I would like to try it out. Sounds like it's amazing. So if you go to Teavana, when you get the tea, you can get the sugar. So the next thing I want are some charms for my bracelet. For my birthday, my boyfriend got me the Charmed Memories bracelet from K's, and I just like to have some more charms to it and some holders, just because when I write, the charms like get in the way, basically like stab into my arm while I'm writing. So I like some holders, or stoppers I think they're called, to stop them up here so that they don't get in my way when I'm writing. Next thing I would like are some iPhone cases, just because I've had my phone for over a year now. I got the iPhone 5S when it first came out, so I just like to have some new cases to make it feel like I have a new phone, even though it's gonna be a while before I get a new one. Next, I'd like a monopod, preferably not a cheap one, which is why I'm putting it on my Christmas wish list instead of something that I can buy for myself, because a cheap tripod's okay, there's three legs, but a monopod, I would be using it to like cover something that I can't really reach, so I might have my camera on here and I have it like reached out, like scanning over something. And let's say like, I would never do this because as you guys know from my other video, I'm not a nature person. But if I was on a hike and I wanted to, I don't know, film the cliff down below because I'm that crazy, I don't want a cheap tripod and like it like cracks from the weight of my camera and my camera goes tumbling down the cliff. So I'd like a more durable one, especially with a like squishy grip. Also, I would like a new, or some more actually, pom-pom hats. I really, really like them, like the ones that have like a little furry ball at the top. I'd like a couple more of those. I don't want black, but any other color would be fine for me. I got this flannel t-shirt from Walmart. As you guys should also know from my previous videos, I love Walmart. I do not mind buying things from Walmart. If they have cute things, I will buy them. And while I was there for Black Friday shopping, most people were there for just like TVs and, you know, electronical stuff, tablets, stuff like that, electronical. I came across this box full of these flannel shirts. They were just different colors, and they were in the men's section. They were only $7. So the smallest size that they had was small, and I'm not a small girl, but the small was kind of big for me, and they didn't have an extra small. I put it on and it kind of looked nice, like it looked nice and oversized. So I'd like a couple more of these. Another thing that I want isn't a tangible item, but it's pretty much like the number one thing on my Christmas wish list this year, and that is to spend Christmas in New York. I live in Pennsylvania and not too far from New York, and I've lived in the city for a while. My dad still works up there, and I've never been to the big tree in Times Square. So this Christmas, I want to go visit the big tree. I'd also like to go and, you know, go to like a really nice restaurant. I love getting dressed up and going out to like fancy restaurants. It literally makes me so, I don't think I've ever even been to a restaurant where it's like jackets required, only like fancy tablecloth, and just, oh, I just love that type of stuff. So I want to do that, and yeah. So Christmas in New York with my boyfriend and go to a really nice restaurant is what I want to do. Well, not actual Christmas Day, but like, you know, sometime during the month of December. Also, another makeup product is the Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade. I think it looks kind of nice to just use it once in a while, so having that would be pretty nice. And I don't know, it just, I like the way that it looks on everyone's eyebrows. I just wouldn't do it every day. I also like some new shoes. I really don't have a lot of shoes. Hello mother, hello father. Over the knee boots I really need. It's preferably ones that are stretchy because my calf muscles are very like thick. Another thing that I want for Christmas, and sorry for the lighting change, it got really dark out of nowhere. The sun just does not like us here in Pennsylvania. Another thing that I really want, which is like really important for me to get, is a camera purse. So basically like a purse that has compartments for you to put your camera in, and like the soft cushioning around it to keep it protected. I'd like to bring my camera if when I go spend Christmas in New York, not if, when, because we're doing this. But I'd like to bring my camera with me, but I don't really want to walk around with a camera and, you know, risk something happening to it or getting stolen, it getting broken. And I don't want to have a camera bag and a purse, or just in general when I want to take my camera out. But I think having a camera purse would be really, really, really good. I'm not necessarily asking for one from Ona Bag or anything like that, or onabags.com, I forgot what it's called. I'm not necessarily asking for that one. I don't need all the bells and whistles. There's some very nice ones on eBay and Etsy, but a camera purse, not the ones that are like boxy that look like a camera messenger bag, but like ones that look like a legit pocketbook. So yeah, one of those, mom, dad will. Socks too. I got my first pair of fuzzy socks over the weekend, and oh my god, I love them. So daddy, if you could get me some more fuzzy socks, will, some over the knee socks, some thigh high socks. I don't have any of those, so that'd be really, really, really greatly appreciated. But yeah, fuzzy socks rule the world. I'm wearing a pair right now. Fuzzy socks. Oh, some boot socks. Socks. The last thing that I have on my list is the NYX Curve Eyeliner. I've had the Milani Curve Eyeliner, but I see a lot of people are really buying this one. They really seem to like it. I do think that using the Curve Eyeliner does make it a lot easier to do your eyeliner, but I don't know what the difference is between the NYX and the Milani, because I saw $14.99 and I was like, skirt! So, I'd like to try out the NYX one, and, you know, maybe like the color is more vibrant or something. So, I would definitely like to try the NYX Curved Eyeliner. And just, you know, you never have too many eyeliners. So that's pretty much it for my wish list. I feel like there was a couple more things that I was really wanting or interested in, but for the, you know, that's a pretty good list for me. There's a couple other things that I want, but I kind of already know that I'm gonna get them for myself by the end of 2015. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I will be back next week for another video, and I hope you guys enjoy your day. Bye!